Hey there, I'm Cesar. I did a PhD in computer science, and last week I caught up with a colleague of mine who is currently in the last year of her PhD. So I asked her, you know, the usual, "So, how are you doing? Writing your thesis?" And she looked at me and said, "Well, actually, I'm still working on my last paper, or this is what I hope." And I could see the mix of fatigue and resignation on her face while she was saying this. So it got me thinking, why all this pressure for one more paper when I know that she already have a lot of papers published? Why adding all this stress right at the end of the finish line of a PhD? These are reasonable questions, and having been in her shoes, I totally get it. The reason for this is what I call the last paper's myth, a widespread issue among PhD students who are very close to graduation. It is a tough reality in academia, and today I'm going to dive into this topic. So in this video, I will share my thoughts on the expectations and realities when finishing a PhD. I would also like to touch on this issue from a broader and maybe philosophical perspective beyond academia. And again, my goal is to provide actionable insights for PhD students and researchers on how to identify, address, and also navigate the pressure at the end of the PhD journey. So let's begin talking about expectations. As PhD students, we started our journey envisioning the PhD as a quest for knowledge that will open up professional doors for us. A PhD is supposed to be about satisfying our curiosity, and at the same time that we make contributions to science and perform scientific research. But in recent years, I think this ideal has shifted dramatically. Nowadays, universities are under a huge pressure to get more and more funding from public agencies, at the same time that there is a significant increase in the competition among universities to run higher on global publication rankings. It seems to me that high education is a matter of prestige, and this prestige helps university to secure even more funding, which allow these institutions to hire the best people. It's like a never-ending cycle. So I remember at the end of my PhD, I felt very happy about the idea of finishing the whole thing and taking a break. So don't get me wrong, I actually love doing research, but 5 years as a PhD student is just a long time. And after so much hard work, taking a break was like imperative to me. So back then, I thought that, okay, my main task for this final year is to compile my research into a thesis, and that's it. I was very lucky, having, of course, a few papers already published in good conferences and journals, all of them contributing to the same field, which made me feel like, okay, I have accomplished a real PhD after all. So I think many PhD students feel this way as they approach the end, like thinking they need to focus only on writing the thesis. But it turns out that the more paper we make, the new research opportunities emerge, and this means more papers that we can write. So suddenly all these opportunities made the end even more difficult. And it's important to realize that the end of a PhD is often a clash of expectations, because most PhD students get tired and just want to be done. But on the other hand, their academic supervisors and the institutions behind them have their own agendas. I mean that once students have shown that they can produce a certain number of papers, they become very, very valuable assets for both the supervisors and the universities. Why letting such a valuable assets when they are at the peak of performance? That's the question, so. And that's when the push for just one more paper begins. So it's frequent to push students to make just another paper. And somehow, students feel that they have to do it in order to fulfill all the academic expectations. And I think that this situation is not good, it's not a good idea for science. It's like prioritizing work output over well-being can leave to the most capable students feeling that they are burdened, and then that end could at the end could demotivate them to continue in academia. So the last paper's myth keeps PhD students in a loop under the false belief that they need more results to graduate, but this is far from true. So in reality, the notion that a specific number of papers can define the end of the PhD is a misconception. I think that productivity and impact in science are not just about numbers like publications or citations. Research quality, impact, and contributions vary widely across fields and are often subjective. Like, for example, for those doing research in theoretical computer science, often one paper is enough for them to defend their PhD. But on the other hand, in software engineering, for example, which was my field, you probably need at least 3 papers published. So on a personal level, the push for more paper often reflects a conflict of interest between the students who need to graduate and the desires of supervisors and institutions for more academic output. In the case of supervisors, they just need more publications to boost their own careers. And especially for young supervisors, they have a lot of energy and are still building their careers. So it is normal to expect from them to push more pressure on the students. And that's just what it is. I think that recent findings show that while some students benefit from this push by enhancing their CVs, others feel overwhelmed. The pressure to publish a paper at the end of a PhD can delay the defense unnecessarily, adding financial and emotional stress. We need to take into account that often PhD students already have papers under review once they graduate. So at the end, these papers will need to be revised after getting their reviewers feedback, right? They need to be resubmitted and so on. So technically, it's a lot of unpaid work that goes after the defense. But what can we do to countermeasure this? I think that to countermeasure the pressures of the last paper's myth, there are a few strategies that we can carry out at both individual and institutional levels. At the individual level, I think that PhD students should set clear boundaries and communicate openly about the expectations and needs with their supervisors. Like, for example, asking, how many papers do I need to graduate? Or just letting very clear the fact that writing the thesis is very, very important. On the other hand, academic departments can implement policies that promote transparency and accountability about the requirements for PhD students. So if you are a PhD student and find yourself stuck in a cycle of writing papers when you should be writing instead, I think it may be the time to reassess your priorities. And again, open communication with supervisors in case of feeling stress and being clear about the fact that writing a thesis requires a deep work and focus is very, very important. It's possible, having a mutual agreement on the number of papers expected, for example. And this could also prevent misunderstandings and stress later on. I think another tactic is to immerse fully in the thesis writing and make everybody aware that you are not available for any other task. I think that showing this very high level of commitment to your thesis writing process can help to prevent having any additional tasks. The core idea behind this phenomenon is present in various professional fields as well. Like, for example, in some circumstances, the people in power often prioritize personal gains over the well-being and development of those that are lower in the career ladder. And this is particularly evident in the corporate world, where highly productive employees often end up with disproportionate workloads when approaching deadlines, for example. And this is similar to the academic pressures to publish more papers and definitely calls for a critical examination of ethical practice across all professional fields. So in this video, we have explored the phenomenon of the last papers myth in academia, where the interests of students and the academic system often get in conflict. And I believe personally that increasing awareness and setting clear boundaries and definitely can definitely help PhD students navigating the final year more effectively. It is also good to remember that this issue isn't just limited to academia. It extends to the corporate world as well, where talented employees frequently face similar pressures. Anyway, good to remember, whether you are finishing a PhD or climbing the corporate ladder, setting clear and measurable expectations are crucial for a balanced and successful ending to any chapter in life. See you in the next one. Bye.